Hello everyone, my name is Suman. Today I am going to explain about Hindu, about the Hinduism and Buddhism, about these two religions. I am going to explain what does Hinduism and Buddhism stand for, what do these religions propagate, what happens of life after death according to these religions. I am going to explain to you. Now, first let's look at this thing. Why people have different mindsets? Why every person has a different mindset? Why two people don't perceive same thing differently? Why a person likes X food so much and the other person hates that food? Why all these things happen? Let's look at it. Now this individual human being, if we take this this as an individual living being, this individual living being has gunas. Every individual living being has a guna, and this guna is further divided into sattva, rajas and tamas. Okay, this is something like the software of the mind. Just like we have this software, this for this phone. For a human being, guna is more like a software which runs his innate nature. What he thinks, how he perceives this world, what are his emotions. All this is controlled by the gunas, and gunas are further divided into sattva, rajas and tamas. And if you say, if you look at this sattva, rajas and tamas, sattva is pure, luminous. Free from distress. It's like, sattva is like a path of knowledge, a path of serenity, a path of simplicity, a path of happiness. We can take sattva as like that. Rajas is a path of vigorous action. It has so much of passion in it. Doing action with so much of passion and attachment, anxieties, restlessness. These are rajas. Tamas are complete delusion, illusion, ignorance, carelessness, lethargy, sleeplessness. So these are the three gunas which every human being is made of. Every human being is made of sattva, rajas and tamas. One which is pure, illuminous, path of knowledge is sattva. Relentless activity, anxiety is of rajas, tamas is of lethargy, ignorance, delusion. So each and every human being on this planet Earth has a proportion of gunas. One guna will be predominant, other two gunas will be in different proportions, like 60, 20, 20, or some kind of a proportion they will have. Now, this human being made of sattva, rajas and tamas perceives this nature, perceives this material nature. Now this material nature is made up of earth, water, fire, air and wind. And further, if you look at this material nature has sound, sight, smell, taste and texture. So this human being, this individual human being, with his senses, with his five senses, ears, eyes, nose, tongue and skin, looks at this nature, five elements of nature, and sound, sight, smell, taste and texture. Now, when the interaction between the senses and sensates happen, sensations happen. When senses and sensors come into interaction, sensations in body happen. Now this sensation can be further divided into these sensations are of like and dislike. You know, whatever you see in the world, you may like it or hate it. You may see it as us or others, hate or love. Yes or no, these are the sensations you have. And these sensations will lead to desire. I want that thing. I want that bike. I want that girl. I want that whatever that material nature is. This desire. And these desires can be divided into further like Arishadvarga, Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, Madha and Matsarya. So, Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Madha, Matsarya is lust, anger, greed, attachment, pride, jealousy. So, if you take a human being, a human being is made of gunas, sattva, rajas, tamas of different proportions, and he interacts with this nature. Nature made of sound, sight, smell, taste and texture, he will interact. Out of those interactions, sensations will happen. And these sensations will be of like and dislike. Out of sensations, desires will happen. And desires will be of many of things. In this way, an ego happens. I, Suman. I, X, Y, Z. My likes. My habits. My country. My gender, all these things, this is how I will happen. And this I perceives the nature in a different way. Some other I perceives the nature in a different way. That is the reason why people have different mindsets. It's predominantly because of gunas. Because rest of the things, senses, nature, all are same. But except this gunas and their proportions, because of that these differences, the way they perceive the nature and how they understand this material world will be different. Now, the percentage of sattva, tamas and rajas in each individual human being is of different proportion. That's why each individual perceives, understands the same nature in different ways. So what Hinduism says is, what is the ultimate purpose of human life? What Hinduism says is, this is called moksha in Hinduism and nirvana in Buddhism. This is about liberation. This is the highest state of human life according to Hinduism and Buddhism. So human being interacts with material world. Interaction between human being and material world. So the purpose of human life is in the starting stages, understanding the interaction between human being, and first we need to understand how human being interacts with material nature. Next, what is dharma? Dharma is following nature and its rule. We live in this material world, and this material nature has all those physical rules on which everything is built up. If we go against the nature, all kinds of natural calamities will happen, like climate change, the rise of sea levels, different kinds of viruses, this coronavirus. If we don't follow the nature's rule, the nature will hit us back. So dharma is following the nature and its prescribed rules for the human beings. Adharma is going against the nature. So what a human being, the purpose of human being according to Hinduism is, the person should slowly understand how these desires come from, how this desire comes from. The desire comes from the interaction between senses and sensates. From this interaction between senses and sensates, the desire comes. So the person should understand the root cause of suffering is desires. Minimizing the desires will solve all the human problems. There are 700 crore people in the world, and Earth is a limited planet. It cannot give everything what a human being asks. This unlimited desires of human beings cannot be fulfilled by Mother Nature. So a person being should understand this and and slowly he should reduce his desires. He should just understand that senses and sensates are interaction, and he should not, every single time, he should not get attached to those desires. So he should minimize the desires. When you minimize the desires, the likes and dislikes of those desires will also be reduced. So duality, the duality of like and dislike will be automatically reduced. And the person should propagate these teachings in these initial stages. The person should propagate the teachings of Bhagavad Gita to the rest of the society. That the desire is the root cause of all the problems. The mother nature cannot provide everything a human being asks, because the nature is limited. Desires are unlimited. Desires in your brain are unlimited. 700 crores people asking unlimited, 700 crore unlimited desires cannot be fulfilled. So understanding that the desire is the root cause of human suffering, and reducing your desires and propagating these teachings to the rest of the society, you should do. In the later final stages, you need to transcend your body. You need to understand that this is not I. I am not this gender. I am not this caste. I am not this religion. Whatever I as a bodily attachment you have, you need to transcend that. Transcending the desires. Transcending desires completely. You should become desireless. Transcending the gunas. The sattva tamas, the sattva, rajas and tamas, you need to transcend even them. After transcending those things, transcending ego also, I. When you transcend even ego, I also, transcend all these things, at this stage, soul, your individual soul, becomes one with the source of the creation, the supreme soul. Okay, let me explain this again. When you don't think about yourself with this body, if you don't say that I am this body, and when you transcend the desires also, when you transcend the gunas, which are the source of all these desires, even if you transcend the I itself, I Suman, whatever I, the gunas, the desires, the body, if you transcend everything, the soul, the individual soul and the supreme soul are one and the same at that time. Because there is nothing called as I, the individuality itself is evaporating. So this is the ultimate purpose of human life according to Hinduism and Buddhism. These are the very teachings Buddha and Lord Krishna taught in Bhagavad Gita. The Buddha's teachings and Lord Krishna's teachings are one and the same. Maybe in saying they may have some differences, but these teachings are one and the same. So finally, I would like to say again, a person should transcend his desires, this unlimited desires, which is source of all the suffering, and he should live in harmony with the nature, because nature is limited, human desires are unlimited. Slowly he should reduce his desires, he should live happily with mother nature. And he need to transcend his gunas, his ego, I. This is how he will reach his ultimate goal. When the soul itself means nothing, then you reach the supreme soul. Thank you.